Welcome to Editorials in 8 Minutes from Padho India, and this is Ishan Arora. Today is the 4th of January, and the first editorial we have today is Breaking Barriers. The key is to allow women to pray at Sabarimala in an orderly way. This relates to an incident where Bindu and Kanaka Durga, women of menstruating age, have entered the Sabarimala shrine. Now, it is the first time after the Supreme Court order of September 2018 that women of the menstruating age from 10 to 50 have entered the shrine. But it has done in secrecy and with help from the police. As the news spread, there have been violent protests. Therefore, it is not a sustainable solution. We need to ensure safe passage and peace in the area in the long run. After this incident took place, the priest ordered for purification of the temple, and this has led to a controversy. Now, Justice Chandrachud, in the verdict, said that the act of not allowing women to enter is an act of untouchability and violates liberty, equality and dignity. So, we should work in the manner to provide equality to women. Now, the next editorial is Dark Side of the Moon. Now, this is relating to China's successful mission will greatly advance knowledge of the Earth's satellite. Now, China's Chang'e 4 landed on the moon, that is Chang'e 4, on Von Karman crater on the far side. Now, this is the third country after USA and former USSR to land on the moon. Now, the special communication satellite known as Qiqiao has been specially launched to make communication with it, as direct communication is never possible with this because the far side never faces the earth. The instruments which are placed are cameras, low frequency radio spectrum analyzer, lunar neutron and radiation dose detectors, among the many more. Now the help will be, it will help us understand the evolution of the universe, understand exoplanets and structure of the universe just after the Big Bang. Editorial also compares the near side and the far side of the moon. The near side faces the earth and the far side never faces the earth. The reason for this is given in the NCRT. Now, it has dark patterns, whereas the far side only has circular spots, which are made by craters, which are craters made by meteorite strikes. The near side has thinner shell, and when the crater hit them, they were filled by lavas and leaving dark spots. Now this side, far side, is thicker and the lava did not come out, so the craters have been the same. Now the near side is exposed to radio waves from the earth, whereas the far side is shielded. Hope with concerns in 2019, 5 issues need to be addressed comprehensively if India needs to achieve sustained growth. This is written by C. Rangarajan, former RBI governor. This relates to economic outlook for the new year. Globally, there has been higher growth, but the trade war has also come back. Domestically, first quarter growth was high, but rupee oil prices are not stable. The growth estimated by RBI is 7.4%, but Mr. Rangarajan thinks that it will be lower because international environment is not conducive. Our exports will be very low, much lower. Major concern is the investment ratio. GDP depends on investment rate and productivity of the capital, means the amount of money you will put in and your productivity, or incremental capital output ratio. It means extra money required to increase the productivity of GDP. This depends on quality of labor. So we need to provide skill, education and use of technology. Second is the banking system. There are a lot of NPAs. 16.7% NPAs in the PSB are existing as of March 2018. Now, prompt corrective action has 11 banks placed into it. NBFC are also under stress. So, from where will we get the investments? As banks are stressed, their inability to lend will affect the investment. Next is employment growth. The GDP is growing at around 7%. But why not the employment? Growth can be by two reasons. One is you better utilize the existing resources, or you invest more to buy more resources and then bring in growth. In our case, the present growth is happening because we are all making better use of existing resources. So, jobs created will be much less in this scenario. Since 2004 to 2010, there was high employment generation because there was rapid growth in the IT sector and the financial sector. But at present, both these sectors are stagnant. India's growth is linked with the outside world. 42% of our GDP is growing because of trade in goods and services. Therefore, we have become vulnerable to international fluctuations such as trade wars, export promotions, oil prices, and dollar strengthening. There is a lot of agrarian distress. We need to consolidate land holdings, increase productivity, improve marketing and value addition of goods by food processing industry. This can be done to overcome the agrarian distress. Next is a case of unprincipled criminalization. The Triple Talaq Bill is a classic case of unfair legislative move with a populist agenda. Now in the introduction part, what the person is saying is, it refers to an essay by Martin R. Gardner, who asked a question that illicit motivation to pass legislation, can it be a grounds of unconstitutional? Now, he says that significant sectarian motivation without a secular purpose can be a ground for invalidation. In the Shaira Banu case, Talaq-e-Biddat was declared unconstitutional by the Supreme Court. Now, the parliament is passing the Muslim Women Protection of Rights Bill, and the statement of object and reason is given as follows. It will give effect to the Supreme Court order, and it is not acting as a deterrent, as we still see such cases. The verdict, it is talking about the verdict is not acting as a deterrent. Now the author says that it is self-implementing, and Supreme Court did not ask the parliament to make a law. Hence, the first thing here to give effect to the order is invalid. The second part is that it does not make any difference even if still people are saying triple talaq, because things will not actually happen. He compares dowry and talaq. He says that dowry is illegal, but when such an act takes place, there is actual transfer of money. But triple talaq is invalid. So if someone says talaq three times, actually talaq will not take place. So how can you criminalize this act? So this is all of the editorials today. Thank you so much. Please share, like and subscribe. And you can also join the Telegram group given in the description.